Now we are discussing about n rows. If we have some 1000 lines or 1000 rows or 1 lakh rows in the CSV file, we want some 100 rows or 500 rows in our data frame. Then we can import only those 100 rows by using the n rows. For example, previously we are discussing about, we have used skip rows, first 3 rows we have skipped. Okay, let us consider I have skipped only starting 2 rows. This time I have Google, WMT, okay. I have some 5 rows. This time I am mentioning, I want only 3 rows. So I am mentioning n rows is equal to 3, which means only starting 3 rows will be imported, and with those three rows only data frame will be created. If I mention n rows equal to 2, only 2 rows will be imported, with those 2 rows only data frame is created. This time I am not using header none. So when I am not using header none, I am only skipping first row, example. Then n rows equal to 2, starting 2 rows. So if I use n rows equal to 3, these are starting 3 rows. N rows equal to 4, these are starting 4 rows. So this is very useful when we have a very huge amount of data and we want to import some rows, and those imported rows, data frame will be created.